It's the Game of the MTGO Show.
I'm going to take the pack one, pick one fourth here. I think you win more games off fourth than Monkey. Obviously, Monkey's one of the best one drops in the game. Let's see, how long did that take me? I guess there was some travel. There was some travel at the start of the Baldur's Gate stream. So Sacred Foundry would be, like, good for our lane, good for our fixing. Mana Vault seems perfect with fourth, though, right? You can just, like, turn two fourth for three. Oku for the most ambitious. For the most ambitious drafters, just all the colors. I wonder if Sam Black Oko's there. So Plunder would let us keep the aggression on, whereas Fractured Identity would put us in the Jeskai range of things. Actually, I wonder if Counterspell is better than Fractured, if you are doing that. Fractured easier to be in a three-color deck. Or do I just want to be aggressive? Do I just want to take Plunder? Plunder solos some opponents. The Treasure Generation is good with fourth, too. Yeah, I'll just take this. Some nice blue cards there, though, huh? Savai Triome is fixing. I guess I'll grab it. I've been kind of impressed with Carnosaur. That card's been growing on me. Pest Infestation's really good. How did Baldur's Gate end up last night? Last night, I made it to the final boss, and then after two attempts, I was like, there's no fucking way. Like, my brain was fried after streaming for 11 hours. And so then I finished him up. I finished him up at the start of my stream here. Went back to town, got some magic arrows. They were very helpful. It was cool. Cool little fight. Yeah, overall, I'm happy with the run. There were definitely some fights where they were, like, extremely sloppy. But there were some clean ones over the course of it, too. Some that I was happy with. Looking at Sunbaked Canyon. Talisman of Creativity. Talisman, bigger fourths. Let's take the fixing, huh? Well, I was kind of thinking about playing Splashing Blue earlier. Ooh, Headliner Scarlet or Ancient Tomb. Give me that Ancient Tomb. Eevee Geddon, thanks for the sub. Thanks for the 19 months there. How'd that game hold up as far as aging? Baldur's Gate 1? So, I think the graphics hold up pretty well. All the, like, the still paintings and stuff. All that art, I think, holds up pretty well. And it is the extended edition, so a lot of the splash screens have been updated and such. The quest design and writing and stuff, I think, is all really good. There is a little bit of 90s fantasy writing in there, if you know what I mean by that. So stuff that hasn't necessarily aged well, but good for being a product of its time. And I don't think there's anything egregious in there. Just random bits of misogyny and what. In the dialogue for flavor. But yeah, largely the writing is good. The writing, the character design, all that stuff. Classic for a reason. Grabbing Wrath for the sideboard isn't crazy. I'm going to take Spellbinder here. Glorybringer is perfect. Exactly what I'm looking for. All this acceleration. Overall, I thought it held up pretty well, but it's also a game that I've got some nostalgia for. The D&D edition. Yeah, I mean, second edition's pretty brutal, but I think it has its charm. Second edition is like, it's like driving like a classic car, right? It's like the speed is a little clunky. It might be a bit of a death trap if you get into an accident. Bit of a bumpy ride, right? Bit of a bumpy ride. Yeah, fucking more dragons, right? We're listening to Dragon. But people, I mean, collect cars for a reason. It's, again, not without its charm. The early levels in second edition are particularly brutal. Rolling well or poorly in a fight, you're like, your whole party might just get murked. Or it might be the easiest fight of all time, right? Which is part of what makes those games so replayable, right? No two runs are going to be the same. So one of the reasons people go back and play Baldur's Gate 1 and 2 over and over and over again. Oh, the Canyon Wield, nice. Y'all, the Boros fixing that I wanted came back. Happy Friday to you, Maxwell. I agree, Nooch, the song does rip. What do I think about Arena of Glory? It's awkward. So like, if you're giving, like, Hero Blade Hold Haste, that's obviously awesome. Or Flage, that's really good. A lot of Red's top-end threats already have Haste. So, overall, I like it. But I don't pick it highly. Any big plans this weekend? Yeah. Yeah, tomorrow, I've got a 5K. The hashtag MTG Creators 5K. That's going to be standard. I'm going to be starting streaming early for that. And then after that, I'm going to be jamming some feeder leagues in cubes, see if I can get a 4-0 or two. And then on Sunday, I'm going to go see High on Fire in Chicago. And that should be a good time. Yeah, I'm just going to get nabbing off color mocks, huh? Not too much to think about here. Library and Athari would have been both fine first picks, you know, pack two, pick ones. We got a max. Ooh, little Fable action. I like that Wooded Foothills, too. You don't think that's really changed with later editions of D&D? Early levels are the most dangerous in modern D&D? Yeah, I mean, early levels are the most dangerous. I think they're, like, particularly brutal in second edition, though, by comparison. I think more people are going to get murked in the early levels of Baldur's Gate 1 and 2 than they are in Baldur's Gate 3. For example, I love this raptor. I think the raptor would be great here. Off Ancient Tomb and stuff. I'm going to take Chromox, though. Just keep on stacking fast mana. Any general tips for drafting Vintage Cube? Try and find out what lane is open. Being in whatever lane is open is going to be most important to having a cohesive deck at the end of it. And don't feel bad if you have to, like, waste your first couple of picks if you don't end up playing them. Because once you get into that open lane, you're going to have so many playables. Vintage Cube doesn't really have dead cards, right? Or at least not very many. Yeah, constantly thinking about, like, what you're giving up for what you're getting is a good way to approach those picks. So I'd be taking, like, a best card for this other archetype and giving up a medium card for the colors that I'm already in. Type deal. And then, of course, there's something for sending... there's an argument for sending consistent signals, too. Flame Slash is great here. Nice little fish and removal spell. You need some removal, right? Gotta have some. Not huge on Esper Sentinel. I think our curve is just, like, going way above it really quickly. I don't think I can splash that short guy, though. I think getting blue mana in here would be difficult at this point. Oh, she went up. Hey, Klugalters, thanks for the sub. Thanks for the 14 months. Appreciate you. Olivant's an option. Olivant's very castable in this deck, and it pitches to Chrome Monks. Blade Splicer also an option, right? We got this Ancient Tomb here. We can play it pretty quickly. Something to blink with Philia, right? Alright. Oh, Olafon would have been a thing to pitch to the Detective's Phoenix, too. Pitches to Chromox and Detective's Phoenix. Maybe it's better than Blade Splicer. They're both great here, right? Kind of hard to tell which is better in that spot. I wish I could trade this Esper Sentinel for an Olafon. I'd give him an Esper Sentinel and a Seasoned Pyromancer for an Olafon. Excuse me. Splicer's so cozy to you. I mean, Blade Splicer is like a classic Vintage Cube card now. It's weird because it was like a new card for so long. The new card that came in and made cards like Savannah Lions look like dog shit, right? Hey, Big Jimbo, thanks for the sub, thanks for 72 months. Hey, Raptor came back, that's what I was hoping for. A lot of solid green cards here. But yeah, now the curve's looking reasonable. I got a couple of ways of pitching anger. Desperate man. Oh, cool, Micro. You been enjoying it? Your last pick brainstorm happening. I mean, my lane's pretty open, so, like, there's an outside chance a Johnny comes back, but you're not getting anything, right? You're not risking it for any payoff. Johnny's so good. You're ordering a popper cube for your IRL group. Oh, very cool. Hope y'all have a blast. Yeah, I'm just taking a burn spell, huh? Do I want yet another comes to play tap land here? Not really. I almost like that Palantir. Path's pretty good, though. Path's better than a lot of my current removal. What's confusing, Ark? Ooh. So Swords is, like, a top white cube card for sure. But we already have a lot of real nice removal. There's going to be three cards remaining when the pack comes back. I'm thinking really heavily about this Bone Horde, huh? Get one more sick dragon in here. We just have all this nice acceleration, right? Chain Lightning over Jagged Rabbit. Do you not think Chain Lightning is a good card, Ark? Are you confused by one of the most efficient spells, most efficient burn spells of the game being drafted? At the time, we didn't have the Galvanic Discharge or the Path either, right? So we were light on removal. The Rabbit's a good card. It's good with this Detective's Phoenix, too, which I may or may not run. But it shouldn't be confusing when someone takes a Chain Lightning. It shouldn't be like, oh, why'd you take that dog shit card? It's a pretty commonly accepted good card. Good magic card there. I'm just going to grab Vantage here. I like Smuggler's Copter, but Vantage is so free, huh? Our mana base doesn't really have any free fixing. I'll come in with a cost. Yeah, the lane is fully open for sure. Thinking if there's a world that I need this Council's Judgment. I think I'm just going to grab Bone Crusher. One more hot bod. You are not even in an arena stream, Redefined. God, well, you should try again. Hell yes, Dambra. I'm gonna grab another talisman. With the double mox and the ancient tomb, I think we should have just like a fairly accelerated curve here. Fucking all the talismans in the world. You think cutting cards is gonna be rough? I think it'll be okay. Obviously, I don't want triple talisman. I might only want one. Kinda wanna play this seating song. Something like this, maybe. I'm considering either Carnage Interpreters or Pyromancer. Just so I don't run out of gasoline. I can't really play them on curve, though. Because I want to be curving into the top end, right? Yeah, I think this deck's going to be sick. Could play one more card if I wanted to, because the double talisman in here can basically replace a land. Get the seating song in. The deck for the standard 5k. It's a deck I haven't played yet. I registered blue-white artifact aggro. A deck that I played against twice at the energy 5k the other weekend. But I haven't actually jammed any games with myself. But I thought it looked really good in the matches that I played against it. So I'm jamming it cold. No games played. Probably silly on my part. I have a lot of reps in with blue-black midrange. Blue-black midrange is, like, pretty solid right now, so I should probably just be jamming that, but that's a free-to-enter tournament. Not the worst place to get a little bit of practice, huh? Try something else out. Yeah, the seating song is mighty tempting here, but maybe it shouldn't be. And the Carnage Interpreter is the last thing that I'm kind of considering. This is a lot of cards stashed into one. I think I might invert these because I have an extra red talisman here. And we need double white as well as double red. Looks like a keep to me. So we do need one more land here, right? But we do have our three mana sources and a couple of four drops. Well, it's something to do at least. Looking at updating Moxfield now. Should be good. Yeah, for whatever reason, it always puts my... Oh, another 4-drop. Perfect. For whatever reason, it always puts my Moxfield decks in my sideboard when I'm doing, when I'm exporting 40 card decks. I messaged the Moxfield people about it, and I never got back. They never got back to me. I don't know if I'm supposed to ping them or something. Hey, there we go. Let's just start spitting out 1/1s. Block, I block. To make a dragon or a wandering emperor, what are the odds that they can cleanly deal with the 4/4 is the main question. Not the worst spot. Could use some Gasseroli though, huh? Some Gasserino. Some of them Dargans. Some of that fourth action, maybe. I'm going to untap this Mana Vault, maybe. Could set me up for a really large fourth later. Can't actually block to save my Archangel because the figure can grow to a 4/4. Bit of a bummer there. I'm trying to decide if this figure, this Death Greeter, is more worthy of getting exiled by the Wandering Emperor, but I guess I can decide at the end of turn. Hmm. Them just dashing it over and over is pretty annoying, but them just pumping figures is also pretty annoying, Not loving my spot here. Holding onto this mountain in case I draw Fable. Hate is but a scratch 5. Things are sharing that prime. How do I feel about that Archangel? My Planeswalker? I mean, it's been good so far. I haven't played it a ton in this cube. I think it's very good in this deck where we're taking a lot of damage from our mana base. And we've got creatures that we want to jump. What creatures we want to give evasion to. Yeah, I feel like we need to either draw some dragons or draw a fourth or something in the near future. This is the sort of spot where, like, a Carnage Interpreter would play really well, right? Okay. Very close to dead here, despite being at 15. 6 plus 8 is 14. Yeah, I think I'm just dead on board. Maybe the soldiers had to stay bang. Not on board, on board. We know that they've got a champion in hand. I'm playing the raptor instead. I think the champion kills me. Maybe it just doesn't matter. They can pump the raptor and sack the raptor to broadside. Yeah, well, they didn't do that. Like, sagging the raptor is 6 damage, right? So, they just gave me one more turn here to rip something good. And we got another land. Yeah, that all makes sense to me. Am I studying or working on something else than this? What are you talking about, Ark? What? Hey, Lion's Eye Diamond thinks the sod needs a video in months. Creatures with flying can block only creatures with flying. Hey, thanks, Lion's Eye Diamond. Go back to school, go get my learning. I heard them. Yeah, I didn't understand them, though. Just gonna jam my giant, and the next turn I can flame slash plus carnage, right? Am I a full time streamer? I am indeed a full time streamer. For almost a decade now. Maybe I should rob her here, But only because it's drawn cards. Ooh. Oh, you're fine, Ark. I just couldn't parse your question. Yeah, I've been a full-time streamer for a while now. Best job I've ever had, that's for sure. Hey, Joe Mama 8630 thinks the sub thinks the 25 months there. Thanks for sharing that prime. Are there other things that I do full-time? So I stream full-time. I do your mother full-time. I drink sassafras full-time. Got that full-time sassafras going. Play Baldur's Gate games full-time. For the past 3 days I did, yeah. That's a lot of mothers. It is a lot of mothers. Servant, huh? Getting that 5 damage in. Dragon. You've been getting back into Baldur's Gate 2? Yeah, that game is sick. I played it, I played a refresher. I played a run right before Baldur's Gate 3 came out, and it was a trip. Thought about streaming it. It sounded like there was a modicum of interest. I mean, streaming Baldur's Gate 2. It's a lot, though. It's a big game. Lubrication helps, Morta Delta. I have played Icewind Dale 1 and 2, both very recently, Hellstorm. A couple years ago, a buddy of mine did the Icewind Dale D&D campaign. He ran the campaign. And so to refresh myself on the setting, I played them through. I tried playing them when I was a kid, and they were too difficult. I just like ate shit and died. I didn't get very far. But they were fun. Some fun level design. The writing isn't quite as there as it was for the Baldur's Gate games. It's very difficult to be mono-red in this cube, I think. Amnetaze. Traditional mono-red had like a bunch of one-drops and stuff, and there's like almost none. Almost none in this cube. Yeah, but the other colors can complement reds. Curve pretty well. True elite. Yeah, I'm not vouching for a goblin guide. What I am vouching for is Swift Spear and the other prowess one drops, right? I thought the pump version of the cube that they had with cards like Monstrous Rage, I thought that was actively good. Excuse me. All right, I still like my sideboard plan there. Full-time sneeze into the beat. Oh, fun, George. Yeah, I've heard really good things about that game. Really like all this acceleration. I just can't cast anything. Doing a quick colored mana source count real quick. Two talismans, timeless dragon is 3, 4, 5, 6, 16, 17, 18 with chrome mox. What happens if I don't rip on turn one but do rip on turn two? Ah, fuck it. Not exactly high stakes shit, right? Let's just jam. See if we get there. It helps that even with a whiff here, we're still doing something on turn one, right? We're still getting the Umazawas down. And the hand plays well with the Umazawas, right? The Blade Splicer. If we can hit... If we only hit a red source, we'll still be fine for a couple turns, because then you got the Bone Crusher Giant and such. Well, they just milled an Archangel Elspeth off the top of my library, so that's useful, I guess. Okay. Hell yeah, McPatches. Glad to hear it. Alright, this doesn't appear to be working out for me. But, you know, we knew there was risks, huh? We knew there were risks. That one exiled a mountain. That's no good. Oh, there we are. I'm going to kill that robber. Right fucking immediately. Because we don't want them casting my angel off that, right? My archangel. No, thank you. Now the pain from Ancient Tomb is starting to look pretty real. Is Bone Hard going to be enough to save my ass here? It's a very real question, huh? No, I've been mind collapsed. How does a mine collapse on a dragon? What's a dragon doing, like, hanging out in the mine? Sniff around for gold and jewels, I imagine. Damn. Oh, well. Man. I have a dog shit opener here. No acceleration. Maybe should have gone to 5. The Hobbit's nothing like real dragons. Nothing like real dragons. For starters, Hobbits are very small. I don't think flame slashing a piddler does much here, right? And they still got their acceleration going. I might be wrong. Yeah. I could blink it now with the dog, but that'd be mean. I don't want to do that. Yeah, Frodo's not even his real name. Yeah, neither Samwise or whatever. Their actual names are real fucked up. Frodo's real name is Mara Labinji or something. Frodo's name in Westron. The words in non-Elvish tongues have been translated for the modern reader. Oh, some Hobbit names are translated while others are not. Sam's true name was Ban, shortened from Banazir, which was then translated to Samwise and shortened back to Sam. That's so easy. Are they dead? They look dead. You're about to start at Vegas 64, man. Looks like you got all 64 people. Let me know if you're a short one. Maybe I can film. But it looks like you're full. Yeah, I'll save my invite. I'll save my invite for next week anyway. I'm going to just make a whole day of it. Assume a couple 64s back to back. Oh, yeah, I meant to do this earlier. Definitely another Pyrokinesis matchup, huh? Are you talking about the true hero of the tale, Pippin? Did I finish Baldur's Gate? I did. Yeah, last night I got a little stuck on the final boss, and I was like, okay, I'm tired. I've been streaming for 11 hours. I just gotta go to bed. And then I woke up, and it only took me like I think 3 tries this morning. I say only. It's kind of a lot of reloads. But it was jolly good fun. Maybe Robert should have gotten in. Yeah, Baldur's Gate 3 is a new patch. Well, goodbye, my things. Hey, lands. Yeah, they block their Pyrokinesis after blocks, because the 2-2's got Trample anyway. And I was thinking I might be able to get their current board plus this Shieldbreaker, if they want to run that out to sacrifice it. Hardcast Fury. Well, that's terrible for me. Sack the Fury. Hell yeah. And patience is rewarded, folks. And patience is rewarded. I think that dragon's gonna tear me a new asshole. That's what I think. Ooh. Think about cashing in the Archangel. Let's get all my shooters back here. Kind of an interesting board. Gonna step away from the Baldur's Gate final fight. How'd it go? Pretty well overall. Yeah, I was stuck on it last night, Svanda, and then this morning I woke up, I looked up some advice online. So I went back to town, I got some dispelling arrows for the final boss, and that helped out a lot. And then I made sure everybody was all potioned up and stuff, and it only took me a couple of tries. So I think it was like 5 or 6 loads total. That boss can take a lot of loads. Same. So just jumping a soldier token and spanking with 3 here is very tempting, right? Put them down to 11. Very tempting with this Fiery Confluence in hand. Could also cash in Archangel, get back Spellbinder, Blade Splicer, a Johnny, and Robber the Rich. Which feels pretty good. And then I'd be playing Fable plus Phalia here. But I wouldn't get any damage in this turn. Ah, fuck it, I've never done this before. Seemed good. It did seem good. I don't know if it was actually good or not. Like, just like getting a smack in might have been great with the flyer there. I guess this ghost fire slice would have just cleared the flyer. Looks like they're splashing Athari for a reasonable splash. Okay. Flesh. Ha. How annoying would it be to play the chain lightning first? Pretty good. That was a good force of will. I kind of don't know what I'm gonna do now. Be able to just draw some mana. Yeah, I mean, if they're force of willing a generous plunder. Seems likely they might have an artifact plan. It's interesting. It's interesting versus the retrofitter plan. If we can resolve, if we can find mana. Ancient Tomb would actually be kind of sick here. Painful, though. All right. Definitely a plunderer matchup. It was its artifacts, right? Sealing Song's not especially good versus counters and such. This is alright. Maybe Umezawa should have come out. Actually, I'm gonna bin this mana ball. Your curve's pretty good without it. Hell yeah, Thopter Gifts. Witchcraft, the last band? It was, yeah. Off the Legend album, I believe. Huh? They had a slow hand, Mary Winter. So they scooped. Once again, I'm very tempted. My hand then needs like one more mana source. I guess I'll send him back. If I whiff on my land, then we can bin Dragon and hold up Tython. Turn two. Might be good. Hey, Alan Pickrell, thanks to the sub, thanks to 45 months, and Thazgar, thanks to 13. Appreciate you both. Okay, I'm gonna just do that. Oh shit, what up? Okay. Should we telegraph the mana tithe? I think I will. Just prevents them from like tinkering or something this turn. Ha ha! The title was in the opening, so now they would have seen it from their bobble. You love that song? Yeah, it's a chill one. Well, chill's the wrong word, but I enjoy it too. Oh, fuck. Hold on. I like F6'd and was my eyes were glazing over and I was like, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Let's get the fucking cat bolts going, We got a dragon stashed in our graveyard, so next turn we might get a full-ass lava axe out of that. Lightning fast reaction speeds. Yeah, reacting to myself, Yeah, I mean, they gotta have a pretty good turn. They have the setup for a pretty good turn. They got Basalt Monolith and Academy here. Are we spinning? Is that the plan? Spinner's a find island. Play island. Spinner's again. Find mountain. Not bad, huh? Not a bad start of the old day. The vintage cube portion, anyway. This is an excellent time for me to take a quick break. I'm gonna go get some water and some tea.